South Korea's role on the front line of the coronavirus pandemic has been raised further as more nations reach out to Seoul for support. Among them now, the United States, as a phone call was arranged yesterday between President Donald Trump and his South Korean counterpart Moon Jae-in. According to Seoul's presidential office, the call was arranged at Trump's urgent request, with the hope of South Korea being able to offer medical equipment support, as he praised the South for handling the outbreak very well. At the risk of upsetting people here at home who might want to fully control the local outbreak first, Moon replied that he would provide maximum support if available. Indeed, Trump did also risk upsetting South Koreans himself, as shortly after his discussion with Moon, he also boasted in a virtual town hall hosted by Fox News that the US has done more tests in 8 days than South Korea has done in 8 weeks, and that American tests are better. These mixed messages are reminiscent of when, earlier this month, Trump downplayed the effectiveness of drive-through testing centers in South Korea before he announced their nationwide introduction in the US just days later. His call with Moon, meanwhile, was held 2 days ahead of a planned G20 teleconference, which may yet set the stage for South Korea to shine again. Officials here confirmed this morning that 4 foreign countries in Latin America, Asia, and the Middle East have asked South Korea to share its know-how in stemming the outbreak within military barracks. Apparently, information about the measures will be shared with dozens of countries via military officials stationed in Korea. And we know the measures include things like suspending certain drills and limiting soldiers' visits and vacations. As of yesterday, the military here had reported 39 coronavirus infections, including 5 civilian workers out of 580,000 active duty service personnel, more than 3,000 of whom have also been mobilized for quarantine and disinfection efforts. And it seems a great example of global cooperation to share whatever might help at this time, and it might even bode well for diplomacy beyond COVID-19.